FTY compilation show, my quirky patchwork quilt of favourite moments and deleted bits from the series. Cue the first clip. Quorum sensing was very first observed in the 1970s. There are some bacteria called Vibrio fisheri, and they live in the bodies of the Hawaiian bobtail squid. Isn't that beautiful?
Wow.
So, the squid gives them accommodation and sugar and amino acid for food, and in return, the bacteria gives the squid the most ingenious defence mechanism by glowing all of them all at once and generating bioluminescence.
That seems like a really fair payment.
Yeah.
Like, you get that incredible party trick just from getting some back... Like, if I got that every time I'd have thrush, I would...
I am so in love with the idea of getting thrush and suddenly being bioluminescent.
Yeah. It would definitely be literally the silver lining.
Yes.
Yeah.
The two most popular Quality Street chocolates are the purple ones and the green triangles, and these should appear, preference, 11 times in the box, and they actually appear just 5 to 6 times.
Oh.
And it's the same with Heroes, Whispers, Twirls...
No wonder this country's the way it is. Most uninspiring country in the world.
Okay.
Just the green one, please. The green triangle that doesn't really taste of anything.
Do you not have favourites?
I hit the toffee finger, I hit the caramel. Those ones are delicious. They are not the same. That's racist. The coffee one's a lot firmer. The caramel one's nice and soft. Give that to an old man with dentures, ask him if they're the same.
I just didn't expect, when I started on this show, that I would watch James call Bridget a racist.
Absolutely appalling what you just said about toffee fingers and caramel cups.
I like that everybody's got a line that they draw somewhere.
I got stuck on a roller coaster at Alton Towers.
Oh, see, my idea of hell.
Yeah, I got stuck in the black hole.
What?
This is the kind of audience I want for my anecdotes.
What is the black hole, darling?
So it's a roller coaster in the dark.
No.
Nightmare.
Yeah.
If I'd have been there, you would have felt a hell of a lot happier. Lighting it up.
And it's one of those roller coasters where you're straddling someone.
Mm. Sorry, you
what?
So you get on and you're both in like a cart and one of you has to sit with your legs out and then the other kind of sits like...
Oh, okay. And you were the one with the legs out?
I was the one with the legs out.
Were you with the stranger?
Yes!
Why? Oh! Where are your friends?
I was in a three and those two paired up.
Okay.
And I wasn't going to, like, miss out on the black hole. And then we just ran out of momentum. I mean the cart, not, like, the conversation. And we were there for about 5 minutes, just sat there. At one point, you could hear the other carts coming down. It's absolutely terrifying. And then they got us off in the end and they went, you can have free tickets to go again. We were like, no!
Just a guy had a soaking wet back from where you pissed yourself.
So a nuclear chain reaction typically takes 50 to 100 shakes. What?
God, I'm going to get this really wrong.
Go on, then.
Go on, then. We'll enjoy it.
Comes some more racism, I imagine.
It'd be so beautiful. It'd be like the, fountains in, what are those fountains called in, the fountains called in Las Vegas where they...
Bellagio.
Oh my God, I cried when I saw those.
They're the ones where they throw her out and land in a hole.
No.
They're my favourite film.
Honest to God, it's like being in an old people's home.
He toured the Middle East, did he?
Yeah, he toured the Middle East.
Right.
I saw a fountain one.
Did you?
OK.
So he toured the Middle East.
So tell
us about the dark room again.
Where are we going on the roller coaster?
You said we was going on a roller coaster. I never piss myself.
I've got thrush.
I love, love, love the music to James Bond. Let's have a quick listen to the original James Bond theme. It can composer is a man called Monty Norman, and it actually comes from a song about a man with an unlucky sneeze, which he reworked into the James Bond theme. It was originally called Bad Sign, Good Sign, and it didn't sound at all like the original song. Have a listen to this.
Some onion bulges, please.
I was born with this unlucky sneeze, and what is worse, I came into the world the wrong way round. Fun
okay, it's all not, stop.
This is surely
no,
bullshit.
This is true. V.S. Lethal's novel, A House for Mr. Biswas, is a wonderful novel, and Mr. Biswas has a terrible sneeze, and it's unlucky for him. And Monty Norman wrote a musical version of this, which was not a huge success. He was later hired to write the music for the first Bond film, which was Dr. No. He reworked the theme tune into the James Bond theme tune. So we thought we'd do a bit of, I'm going to call it karaoke, because it starts with a Q. we're going to try and see if we can sing the original James Bond theme tune. So the words are going to come up on the screen for you. That's what we're going to do.
I was born with this unlucky sneeze, and what is worse, I came into the world the wrong way round. One is all agreed that I'm the reason why my father fell into the village pond and drowned.
I sort of feel like I'd be naturally good in emergencies. Like, I can't speak Spanish now, but I feel like if there was an emergency, I probably could give it a go.
Yeah. What kind of emergency suddenly requires Spanish?
I feel like the Spanish girl, Sandy. She's come in, she's choking. No one else in the hospital speaks Spanish.
Right.
Something's wrong with her.
Yeah.
She can mime, but we're not getting it.
No.
They haven't trained like me in the dramatic art of mime.
Of course.
And so we are. Arriba paella, boys, amaretto. Madrid, Venezuela. And I'm like, don't worry. Penicillin. And then it'll just be like that for...
That poor child is dying and you're the last thing she sees.
Has anyone ever done a poem about jackdaws and backdoors? Because if they haven't, I'm going to do one before the end. Is it really bothering me that it sounds so like a backdoor?
Well, right, the jackdaw and the backdoor does sound like some kind of reverse...
They go together.
Yes, they do. Right, you do that. We'll do the next question on our own.
Jackdaw, backdoor, Lackmore, smack whore. That's where I've got to. Seashore. Crack whore. I'm thinking crack whore as well.
Yeah, what about bee paw?
Beating a bee paw? No, it's got to be.
What am I joining in?
She sells seashells down by the crack whore. Jackdaw flying in the back door.
You carry on, darling.
I've never been happier. Dopamine.
Hacksaw. Oh.
Oh, my goodness.
Hang on, I'm looking at Jimmy Tax Law. Right, you've got one egg, one half cup of buttermilk, 5 teaspoons of baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla, 1 cup of lemon juice, 1 1/4 cups of sugar, 7/8 cups of all-purpose flour and 8 tablespoons of melted butter. Prue, what are the instructions, please?
All right. In a small bowl, beat the egg until foamy.
The egg's foamy or until you're foamy.
No, you've got to beat it up.
Until it's foamy.
Come on, foam up, you bastard!
That looks foamy. What do you reckon?
Is that foamy?
Okay, now.
Yeah.
All right.
Put it in a pan and get the beans warmed up.
No. Add the buttermilk and vanilla.
Which one's the buttermilk?
That's the white one.
Ooh, it's gloopy.
And blended well.
Yeah, so, and the vanilla.
Is that the vanilla?
I was hoping that was a shot of Glenfiddich.
Sandy!
Yeah?
Can I lick the bowl, Sandy?
Not a minute. We've got a bit more work to do.
Add the baking soda, 1 teaspoon at a time, So... sprinkling it and beating until the mixture is smooth and the consistency of light cream.
Alan, you can do this, right? And beating.
Sandy, you just keep that other show where it belongs.
Where's your teaspoon? Let me help you.
Thank you.
How much baking soda? The whole lot?
All of it. Let's get...
OK.
That's cheating.
Thankfully, there's some skills I had as a young man that are becoming useful.
OK. I'm working at Baker's!
Listen.
Right, now what?
I used to charge a fiver for this.
Now...
The right
money. Oh, there was a queue round the block. Yeah, okay, so done that.
Yep.
Pour the mixture into the beaker.
Oh, a beaker, is it?
Okay, pour that in there.
It's gonna be we don't want to go in the beaker! Go in the beaker! Go in the beaker! No! Individual bowl.
Okay.
Do you ever cook with your children?
Everybody. They like the process, but they won't eat anything.
Okay. Add the lemon juice all at once and blend into the mixture.
Blend? How do you? Oh no, I spilt some in the egg cup. Great.
That was fun.
That
wasn't
was really
it?
Good.
It was
what?
Fab.
Is that real food?
No, darling.
This is bullshit.
I mean, Irish people naturally all think they're great singers because of a natural sadness in our necks. Like, give me a song. Give me any song that I might know the words to, and I'll show you what I mean.
Twinkle, twinkle.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I want. Or what you are.
Come down. Now, for a bit of role play, three of you have got police hats under your desk. Addie, I want you to play good cop. Holly, you play bad cop. Alan, you're going to be normal cop.
It's good.
I don't
here
have
we go.
The voice to play a bad cop.
Go for it.
I can't, like, I just, yeah. I can't swear with this voice. It doesn't, like... Give me your fucking secrets. It just sounds delightful.
Nish has a secret. Ooh. I want the three of you to find out what it is.
Please. You look like a traffic warden.
Right.
It looks like someone from the Village People.
Yeah. I think he's about to go to a hen night in Strip.
Right, Nish is in the spotlight.
Oh, my God.
Got a secret. Come on.
This is American immigration all over again.
Go on, you start.
I know you've got something going on, mate.
Wow.
Leave it, you've gone too far.
So much.
Oh, we're a comedian, are we?
Actually, yes.
No, it'd be nice, it'd be nice.
It's a lovely beard you have there, Nish.
Thanks very much, Addie. I've had it combed, and I also really love the fact that you've turned your policeman hat backwards and are wearing it like Samuel
L. Jackson's
Kangol.
That's what I'm talking about.
Hashtag time's up. We can't flirt at work anymore.
Wait, hang on. You're supposed to be the bad cop.
All right, Sonny Jim.
Sonny Jim.
It's bizarre.
I'm sorry about this, Mr. Kumar. It's an absolute nightmare.
It's like being interrogated by Dick Van Dyke and Mary Poppins.
Just tell us what the secret is and I'll call her off.
I haven't got a secret. I'm an upstanding member of society. I've not even taken cocaine, in spite of the size and volume of my nose.
Good cop?
Tell us your secret.
No, that's not good. Good would be like, listen, sir, I'm terribly sorry.
We switched round. Oh, we're switching round.
Yeah.
Tell us your secret, you.
I think it's
Sonny Jim.
Are you going to confess?
I will confess to farting in Sandy's dressing room.
Oh, my God.
Nish farted in Sandy's...
Get them to sign it.
You have a right to remain silent but violent.
I'm really worried, Holly, you're getting into it now.
Start your fight!
I had a situation where I was flying back from Portugal on quite a well-known bargain airline. And then I had to go straight off to do some work. So I wanted to sleep on the almost 3 hours of the plane. And the other side of the aisle seat, there was a Portuguese lady and her 2-3-year-old son who had an iPad. And the iPad was on and it was going bing, ba, bing, bong, bing, 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 bing.
I love that game. Sounds like he was doing pretty well.
I had a brand new set of headphones, but I couldn't converse with this lady. So I went to the crew who were also Portuguese at the back, and I went, I've got these headphones, this situation, I really need sleep, and I'm very happy for them. I can keep the headphones and totally understand, a parent myself, keep my kids distracted, but you know, I really need sleep. He went, no problem, no problem. He goes down there and he snatches the iPad off her and goes, no! 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 And then he takes the iPad and he bonks her over the head.
Oh, my goodness!
Then he turns around to me and went, enjoy your flight.
Oh! You drank the very first cup of tea. Where do you reckon?
Probably in China.
You're absolutely right, it's China. Well, it's a Chinese legend, who knows? It was a Chinese emperor in 2737 BC called Shen Nung, and he's sitting under a tree, and his servant was boiling some water, and some leaves, apparently, from the tree blew into the water, and he thought, I'll have that.
I'm not re-boiling the kettle now.
It's boiled now. That's ages to boil that up. Yeah. Now the leaf's gone in.
And I was watching it.
Leave it in.
Yeah. I think...
So, actually, if you go right back there, it is tea first. Milk never.
Tea first. Milk?
Yeah. Putting milk in that. It's already got leaves in it.
So, I mean, they found out that you can have milk in a tea. Was he drinking tea and a cow just went past and like...
Eureka!
It's a milkmaid having a cup of tea.
Dip the teat in, though, do you?
No.
Listen to them all. Oh. The MP maybe... with the udder there. Can you imagine your own udders going in?
I think it's fair to say you probably can't.
I think honey's nicer than Jack.
Last, the big question.
It's not
is
big...
honey nicer than Jack?
Yeah. What about marmalade?
No.
Get out of there. Marmalade's amazing.
I love marmalade.
Marmalade. No. Do you want it? Would you like it with the rind?
No.
You like it?
No.
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 Yes. This is how we're going to decide.
We'll vote.
The point is, if this
thing
means anything, we're only allowed one spread from here on in.
How many people like marmalade? Let's have a quick vote. How many of you like marmalade? Loads of people like marmalade. Oh, okay.
Hang on.
And of that group, how many of you like it with the rind in? Yes. Oh, mostly everybody.
And who doesn't like marmalade?
Yay!
What is wrong with you?
For people who like marmalade, who don't like marmalade, people who like marmalade, don't put this, you're not involved. People who don't like marmalade, do you like jam?
Yes.
Now, put your hands up, you fools. Yeah. So people who like marmalade put their hands up. People who like jam shout.
Because we're sick of your shit. That's why.
Let's see what people who like honey do.
People... Who likes honey?
They do both.
Because it's in between marmalade and jam, it turns out. It's where the two sides meet. It's the Lib Dems of the...
The way different people queue, you know, around the world can lead to
problems. I had a friend of mine recently in Manchester went to use a cash machine. When he got there to the cash machine, there was a man already using the machine. And 6 foot behind the man, there was a woman sort of waiting her turn. So he says, are you in the queue for the cash machine? And she says, I'm Nigerian, and my religious beliefs are that because I don't know this man and we're not related, this is the distance that I feel safe and respectful, you know, to what I believe in. So, because Steve's a very thoughtful person, he then stands 6 foot away from her, you know. It's like a 12-foot three-person queue out of nowhere. Then the man moved, and the woman moved to the machine to do her money business. Steve then stayed the 6 foot behind.
Perfectly nice.
And he was in his sort of little daydream, and another man come over and said, you in the queue for the cash machine? And Steve went to explain, but not loaded with all the information, said, I am, yeah, but I'm standing here because she's Nigerian.
So this is a very sweet story, OK? This is a story of Romeo. Oh. A Sehuencus frog. So he has been living in a tank in Bolivia in the Cochabamba Natural History Museum, and it was thought that Romeo was the last one in his species. So the last one in his species is called an endling, and in 2018, his conservationist set up an online dating profile for him on Match.com in an effort to find him a mate. And here is the video that they made for their search.
Hi there. I'm Romeo, a Sehuencus water frog from Bolivia. I'm a pretty simple guy. I tend to keep to myself and love spending nights at home. I also love eating. Then again, who doesn't?
Ah, who could resist, right? Who could resist?
They're good friends to do that.
Didn't want to do it himself.
Yeah.
It's embarrassing. It's embarrassing. To do it for yourself.
They're good mates.
Get
They're
your friends to do it.
Miguel, could you do a video for me?
What are you? Get catching the worm. You come out under the rock. You get the worm.
I have the tiny arms of the frog. It is not possible for me to hold the phone. And eat the worm.
Say what you want me to say.
Run it down a big piece of pepper and hold it behind the phone.
The thing is, it worked.
Loads of frogs started turning up.
Good toad in a frog bra.
Hello.
They went out on a frog-finding expedition. They found 3 males and 2 females, and he has now been paired with a female who they have obviously named...
Juliet.
Juliet, exactly right.
See, si, because I am called Romeo. This photograph was taken of me at my modern jazz dance class.
Fancies a Christmas cup stacking contest.
Oh,
shall
yes,
we do this?
Please.
Okay, so you take out your stack of cups.
Yep.
And what you need to do is you need 3 cups here, and 3 cups here, and 6 cups in the middle. So it's a proper sport, it's recognised by the American Amateur Athletics Union Junior Olympics. So here's what you have to do. You have to take the stack on the left and make 3, mm-hmm. like this. Then you have to take the 6 in the middle and make them into a stack as well, like this. And then you have to make the stack of 3. So this is the shape that you should end up yep. with. And once you've done that, in order to do it as a proper sport stacking contest, you then have to return it to how it was, but you have to start the same way and back like this, OK?
Yep.
So, oh are we going to have a competition?
Yep.
Oh see who
God.
Can do this fastest?
Yep. yep.
All right.
This is so exciting.
So start on the... Josh, darling, start on the left. You... Yeah, OK. A stack of 3, a stack of 6, a stack of 3.
OK.
Ready, steady, go. 3 and a 6. And then take them down again from the left to the right.
Come out, you won't come out. Right.
Josh! I think we should challenge you to see if there's somebody in the audience. I'm going to pick. Does anybody want to have a go? Anybody want to go? Okay, the guy just put his hand up here. Come and have a go, my darling. Let's challenge you against Josh. Right. What's your name?
Lee.
Lee, this is Josh.
I've got bad news for you, Lee. You're about to get your ass handed to you.
Okay. Both put your hands on the board before you start. Okay, are you ready?
Not ready.
Go.
Whoa, what's going on there? No!
the...
I'm not going to lie to you, I dropped my first cup. Otherwise, I thought we were pretty well matched. Best of three?
OK, put your hands on the mat, so no cheating.
You think that's going to make a difference?
I do. Ready? Go. You should be ashamed, Josh.
I've ruined Christmas.
You should be ashamed of yourself, cheating at Christmas. Right, boys, hands on the mats. I'm going to give you best of three. Are you ready? Go. ladies and gentlemen, British champion stacker Lee Norton. The chances of being hit by an asteroid is about one in a billion if you go into an
asteroid.
That
would be really unfair.
The chances of anything coming from Mars are a million to one. They say woo, wee, woo, wee.
That song from?
That's from Jeff Wayne's War of the Worlds. When I was younger, we only had one tape in the car for summer holidays, and it was that one tape, and we listened to it for 10 years.
That's a really long holiday.
We had the same with Joseph's Technicolor Dreamcoat.
Oh, yeah.
A flash of light, my golden coat flew out of sight. Colours will determine I was left alone. Was left alone.
May I return?
May I return
to the beginning.
Oh, I did
feel
it.
Oh, yay!
The world and I.
The world and I.
We are still dreaming.
Contains a lot less material than you might think. Why is this skirt
called?
That really was intolerable.
That was terrible. And you, all of you, take us out, please, Mr. Davis.